Proton VPN is undoubtedly a fan favorite VPN. Part of the reason why is that it offers both a free and a premium version. So today in this Proton VPN review, I'm comparing them both. Is the free version enough, or should you upgrade to premium? Before I get into it, please drop a like and subscribe if you want more videos like this one. And now let's talk about Proton. There are so many scammy, data-leeching VPNs out there, especially when you're looking at the free VPN tier. So the first question is kind of obvious. Is Proton VPN safe? Proton is a very security and privacy-focused VPN. For starters, their jurisdiction is in Switzerland, which is a very privacy-committed country. On top of that, Proton uses the latest encryption methods and upholds a clean, no-logs policy, which has been proven to be legit through independent audit. But the cherry on top is the fact that Proton is open source, which means that if you know a thing or two about programming, you can check their code anytime and see the security for yourself, or point out vulnerabilities. But while security measures are the same, no matter if you're paying or not, Proton VPN free versus paid subscription capabilities are very different. With the Proton VPN free version, you can get access to servers in 5 countries. That said, I recently noticed that I cannot select a specific server anymore. I just get connected to the fastest one available at that moment. But hey, at least they don't have any bandwidth limits and don't serve you any ads, which most other free VPNs do. I also found that the free version has a kill switch to prevent IP leaks. And if you go to settings, you can choose the stealth protocol too, which is a very handy feature if you need a VPN to battle internet censorship. One more cool thing that the Proton free version has is a browser extension. It's available on most popular browsers and even Firefox-based forks. It's just that the Proton VPN extension only protects traffic on your browser and is not always the most reliable, as it doesn't always work properly. And honestly, I was kind of annoyed with constant login requests. But limitations are something you're gonna have to get used to with a free VPN app, even if it's one of the best free VPN options. In Proton's case, I noticed slower speeds since there can be hundreds of people connected to the same server. Also, I didn't have any luck streaming. Since you can't choose a specific location anymore, it's almost impossible to get through to foreign libraries. And don't even dream about torrenting, because as soon as Proton detects P2P, the connection will be blocked. So then, is it worth upgrading to a paid plan? Well, if you want more than a basic private connection, yeah. Proton has a premium plan that you can use on up to 10 devices at once. However, keep in mind that Proton can get pretty pricey, as their best discounts are usually hidden under coupon codes, as with most VPN providers these days. So if you want to save a bit of money, check out the link in the description or scan this QR code. Both will apply the latest VPN discounts, and I'll keep the links updated if anything changes. But to truly know if it's worth it, we need to do a bit more of a thorough Proton VPN review of the paid version. First of all, the server pool opens up to a whopping 11,000, spanning across 117 countries, at least at the time of recording this. That's actually one of the biggest server pools among the best VPN options, and I really like that you can use an interactive map to pick a server location, no matter if you're using Proton VPN for PC or mobile. There's also a very big improvement in terms of speeds. While the paid users rely on the same protocol that powers the VPN connection, there is an additional VPN accelerator feature. Basically, make sure that you retain as much of your original speed as possible. I wouldn't go as far as calling Proton the fastest, because if we compare Proton VPN versus NordVPN, you can see the latter is slightly better at speed retention. But Proton speeds will be more than enough for uninterrupted browsing, streaming, and torrenting. Yes. Streaming with the paid Proton plan actually works really well. They have specialized servers for it marked with this play button icon, and I haven't yet encountered any blocks while testing. As for torrenting, you'll notice double arrow signs in the server list, marking P2P optimized servers. If you're an avid torrenter, Proton is also one of the few VPNs that offer port forwarding and a safer version of it than you usually can get. They've configured this feature to resist port fail exploitation, so you can enjoy fast and stable torrenting performance without risking your security. Speaking of specialized servers, there are also ones dedicated to privacy. These onion marked ones route traffic through the Tor network for maximum possible anonymity. Though keep in mind, the cost is a super slow connection. You'll also find security core servers in the app. These are fully owned and maintained by Proton, offering some extra privacy assurance, and they're a bit more gentle on your internet speed. Moving on, I want to mention the NetShield feature. It's an ad and tracker blocker, which also prevents the browser from loading malicious websites. There are more features in the Proton VPN app, but I will leave some of them for you to explore on your own. Don't worry, the app is really easy to use, and there are explanations for features and tools that you won't get lost. If you're looking for additional stuff, Proton actually has more products. They're very well known for Proton Mail, but they also have a password manager, cloud storage, a calendar, and even a crypto wallet now. The only thing that's missing from a full cybersecurity suite is an antivirus. And if they do release that, I call first, all right? Anyway, let me know if you'd like me to do a review of any of the other Proton products, but for now, let's summarize this whole Proton VPN review. So if you are still wondering if you should get the free version or try the premium one, let me put it simply. The free app is great for private internet browsing, and if you're dealing with censorship, it's gonna be a great help. But for all other VPN activities, streaming, torrenting, ad blocking, and so on, the paid plan is the way to go. It's one of the most popular and widely trusted VPNs, so I feel safe recommending it. Just don't forget to grab a discount so you don't overpay for this VPN, as it can get really expensive otherwise. That's it for this time. I hope this video helped you out, and I will see you in the next one.